Some may say many have entered their chambers, but none have ever come back. Some may also say there are the only few members on the planet that understand the art of chess boxing. I just say they're the greatest rap group of all time. Welcome, this is The Bars. Saying it's your boy Tubby and welcome back to The Bars, the best album review show, where I be talking about all the albums that have inspired me over all of the years, over this musical journey, and hopefully it could inspire one of you. So let's get into the album. Boom! This album right here transcended hip-hop. If you ever wanted to understand the sound of hip-hop, this was a go-to album. Even through the music videos and even through the understanding of how they capitalized on their incredible name, you know, and where they were from. Down to the individuals' names in the group were so sick. If you don't know by now, the group and the artists and the album that I'm talking about is none other. I'm gonna see if I can remember the name from the first intro. One second. The RZA, the Jizza, the ODB, aka the Old Dirty Bastard, Method Man, Raekwon the Chef, Master Killer, You God, Ghostface Killer. Oh, I'm gonna go for it. But anyway, it's the Wu-Tang Clan, the 36 Chambers. Let's get into it. If you ever wanted to know the original sound of hip-hop, real street hip-hop, Wu-Tang Clan completely represents and personifies the authenticity of the original sound of hip-hop. It is absolutely mad. All the stories that they tell through their bars is why I genuinely fell in love with the Wu-Tang Clan. When I think a lot of people fell in love with as well was the cult following, it was how they represented themselves as like these greasy kung fu masters, like in their whole thing, which was sick. Like, and it came from the name, from the whole Wu-Tang Clan thing, but the Wu-Tang Clan logo, bruv, everything, to everything being based around kung fu movies. Now my dad was a major, and I think most Jamaican dads have this thing about kung fu movies, bruv, because all I watched was kung fu movies. So boom, the Wu-Tang Clan, I think, first of all, one of the sickest names that's ever came out of hip-hop, all day, every day. Sickest names, to the point where these man made a game. If you don't know, yeah, PlayStation 1, Wu-Tang Clan, I think it's called Bring the Pain, I think it's called Bring the Pain, fam. And I'm telling you now, this game was so sick to see a hip-hop group create a flipping game on PlayStation. Was a mad thing, fam. Man, like RZA, so, hey, bro, Method Man that had like the You God with the big old bird on his thing, bro. The game was like Mortal Kombat. It was a hip hop Mortal Kombat, bro. Are you mad, fam? Are you mad? If you don't know who the Wu-Tang Clan was, a little bit of info. So there's just a group of guys from a place called Staten Island, I believe in New York. I think a couple of them are from Yonkers, like Raekwon the Chef. I might be wrong, but this is from what I know. Boom, they came together. RZA was a dope producer. Still, for me, a very, very underrated producer as well. Super underrated producer as well. I don't think he gets enough credit for what he actually done for the game. So, what I love about them, they kept it 100% authentic, original, organic, strictly Wu-Tang throughout their whole career and bust up the place. They all bought, the thing what I loved about the Wu-Tang Clan as well, they all bought different styles. They were like the Avengers. Like, they were really so individually unique, including their names and their style. Like, Method Man had that famous husky voice with the flows. The Major. And then the GZA had these deep intergalactic lyrics, bro. The Hippocrates, Hypophosis, these he's next wavelength, fam. That's why they called man the genius. He was sick. Raekwon the Chef was real, like, laid back and gangster with it, like, real bossy with it. And then you got Ghostface Killer, who was just straight grease, like, straight thuggish with his very unique voice as well, like, straight cutthroat lyrics. Like, just at your proper... Just, And then you got ODB, he was just, ooh, baby, I like it raw. You didn't know whether he was drunk, angry, upset, happy. You didn't know. But whatever he gave you, he gave you. If this brother's name was in a dictionary, yeah, it will come under man don't care, fam. Bro, it'll come under something like man doesn't care. And he's still a G, bro. He gives it to you raw, fam. So ODB was just my favourite personality and guy in the group. Just as a one, as a whole, fam. You know what I mean? As a whole. And RZA was the poet. RZA was that distinctive, husky, raw, loud. He was the poet. The poet guy. And U-God, to be honest, fam, I think U-God was just ad-lib king, fam. He had, like, three words amongst the tunes. But big up U-God, though. He was, obviously, he done something to be there. You get me? Like, but U-God was sick. Swagger Don as well, bruv. Have I missed out everyone? Master Killer as well. But do you know what? To be honest, with Master Killer, I never really distinctively heard him on many songs. I think Master Killer was their DJ. First things first is the pamphlet. Yes, the pamphlet, fam. This is the most important bit of the album. I don't know how much I've got to stress. This is the most important bit of the album. What I love about this album, yeah, is how they've done everything so unique and so different. From, like, the Woo Bird, and underneath it's got all the information about who they are and how they represent themselves and all the rest of it. But then when you really want to know more information, they've written it like an old school scroll, fam. Like the opposite way, like, so it's all written out like an old school scroll, fam. It is sick. It's just so sick the way they did stuff like this. And like, and this is why up until today, Wu-Tang Clan merch and Wu-Tang Clan merchandise, bruv, it's almost like they're like gold dust. Like, if you got anything to do with the Wu-Tang Clan, I've still got a Wu-Tang Clan shirt somewhere. If you've got anything to do with Wu-Wear, bro, don't get rid of it, fam. I'm telling you, fam, it's like gold dust. This stuff is priceless. Also as well, the maddest thing about the pamphlet, fam, this whole scroll are just shout outs between all of them to their peoples, fam. And it is so hip hop New York, you would not believe. The Wu-Tang Clan would like to say peace to all men. Listen to the names that they shout out, yeah. Ebony, Shaquanisha, Pamika, Lounging Low, the 160 Raid, Drew Lils, Scott Free, Dark Mind, Maddie G, Hesse, DJ Skane, Scott Hawkins, SWV, Buddha Monk, Nasty Nas, big up Nas, you already know who he is. You also know who SWV is as well. So yeah, man, Jaquita, Shaquita, bro, man, really Jaquita and Shaquita, you know, and the first name is Shaquanisha. Fam, they were coming straight from Staten Island to do this thing. Wu-Tang Clan. So yeah, if I haven't mentioned already, this album actually came out in the earliest part of 90s hip-hop. So this came out in 1993, November 1993, recorded between 92 and 93. I believe it got released under RCA with the producer, the main producer, Mr. RZA himself. So like I said earlier, man, he's a genius, bro. He is genuinely a hip-hop sampling genius. What I extremely loved about the Wu-Tang Clan, where they were disregarded about this to the fullest, because all they made prominent was how aggressive their hip-hop is and all the rest of it. But it's their knowledge and the understanding of self throughout this whole album and throughout what they represented. So I believe they were part of a group which came out, I believe, in the late 80s, early 90s, called the 5%ers, which were, they were very, 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 very knowledgeable about the superior mathematics, as they would say. If you ever got a chance to see Busta Rhymes on the Drink Traps podcast, where he talks about someone like Old Dirty Bastard, RIP, who did pass away, he actually says he was one of the most knowledgeable, the most swift with the mathematics and the highest superior of, and the highest superiority of knowledge, as they would say, than anybody else. And he just played a fool one night because that was just his character. So it's super, super interesting. And it's very, very, and it's very, very complex in the way they write music, because you really got to listen between the lines, because all you would hear is the Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing. Wait, there's 9 members in the Wu-Tang Clan. And I believe the 5% has believed something to do with the number 9. So anything godly is to do with the letter number. I might be wrong, to the number 9. So because there was 9 members and there's 3 chambers. Oh, what was it? Aha, I found it. I googled it. This is what I was talking to you about. So, the 5% philosophy known to adherents as the supreme mathematics, which attaches the number 9 with the meaning to bring into existence. Because the Wu-Tang Clan was made of 9 members, each of whom has 4 chambers of the heart. The album was subtitled 36 Chambers, being the total of 9 hearts of the members. Sick, bro. This is why they were sick. That's what I'm saying. Sick. Standout tracks on the album. Standout tracks on this album, of course, were Bring the Ruckus. Bring the Ruckus. Big Boy tune, which was track number 1. Of course, Cream is one of the most famous Wu-Tang songs ever, and one of the most favorite, I believe the word is acronyms in hip-hop. Yeah, like Cash Rules Everything Around Me. Do you know what, to be fair, there's so many standout tracks on this album that made Wu-Tang Clan so big. Protect Your Neck, Wu-Tang Clan Ain't Nothing With, of course. Yeah, there's too many big hits on this album. There was too many big hits on this album, man. Absolute neck brackers, backhand bass slappers, too many. All right, my number 1 pick on this album, for the first time, is a bit of a bait one. But the reason why it's a bait one is because of the longevity. It's because of the storytelling, and it's because of the truth and the reality that the crew depict when you listen to it. And I think that was the beauty of the Wu-Tang Clan, was their truth. How they just didn't care about what anybody thought or felt, and they just said it how it was, and they really just made people grasp their reality at the time and whenever they wrote this song. And again, like I said, probably the most famous acronym that's been used in hip-hop forever and still used up until this day. The video was so trill. It made me feel like I was from Shaolin Island. I was from Staten Island, New York. It really made me feel like that. Like, it's just everything that they did and how they all identified with their persona throughout the track. And you could pick out all of the individuals that are spitting at the time. Bro, it's just sick, fam. It's just, for me, this is hip-hop. You know, this really defines what hip-hop is and hip-hop culture. This is why I love this tune. So my number 1 pick, Cream, Wu-Tang Clan. Cash rules everything around me. Cream gets the money. Dollar bill, yo. I grew up on the crime side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job. At second hands, moms bounced on old men. So then we moved to Shaolin Land. A young dude, you're rocking the gold tooth. No goose, only way I would get into New York was drug loot. And when it started like this, son. If you don't know, that's Raekwon the Chef. But it was just a dream for the team who was a fiend. Started smoking rules at 16. Boom! Today's album review was none other than The Wu-Tang Clan Enter the Wu-Tang 36 Chambers. One of the most creative albums ever made. One of the most creative groups to ever come out of music, point blank, period. They got probably the biggest cult following in the world ever. So if you got anything Wu-wear or anything to do with Wu-Tang, hold on to it with both hands and dear life. If you want to understand the levels to how hip-hop started, the culture representation, the knowledge of different aspects of life and understanding what it was like growing up in the early 90s, in Staten Island, New York, where hip-hop culture kind of began in the area, so to speak, and all of that good stuff, and really knowing about being a wordsmith and being an individual and representing yourself to the fullest, no one else representing yourself to the fullest. Yeah, this is an album I highly, highly, highly recommend. So many artists that you know about today have gained so much knowledge and taken so much of their blueprint to be where they are today. So if you're a hip-hop fan and you really need to be a hip-hop fan, you need to listen to this album. You need to cop this album and you need to listen to it as soon as possible. So that's it. The Best Album Review Show. Thank you all for tuning in. Of course, myself, Tubby. Feel free to follow me on Instagram at TubbyBoyMusic. Please hit that subscribe button so you're notified when I upload. Please like, comment, and all the rest of it. Share, tell the world about your boy. Of course, this is Grown Treasure. Go shop the merch, man. Go check that out, www.growntreasure.co.uk. Yeah, man. It's been amazing. It's been dope. Until next time, love, peace, and chicken grease.